been taught an ill-fated prophecy. Am I right, brother?
That's right.
And so we're going to bring this word out here to you today. And this word is coming out of the book of 1 John. Let's go, brothers.
1 John chapter 1, verse 1.
Read.
That which was from the beginning.
That which was from the beginning.
Which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes,
mm-hmm.
which we have looked upon, and our hands have handled of the word of life.
Read.
For the life was manifested, and we have seen it, and bear witness, and show unto you that eternal life, which was with the Father and was manifested unto us,
mm-hmm.
that which we have seen and heard declare we unto you.
Read.
That ye also may have fellowship with us.
That you may also have fellowship with us. Read, brother.
And truly our fellowship is with the Father.
Uh-huh.
And with his Son, Yahushua HaMashiach.
Read.
And these things write we unto you, that your joy may be full. This then is the message which we have heard of him, and declare unto you, that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all.
God is light, and in him there is no darkness. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He has not changed his word. But when we go to church, we read all these different Bibles that has been changed. And the Bible tells us that we shall not add or take away from this Bible. Am I right, brothers?
That's right.
Read.
If we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not the truth.
If we say that we know him and we love him and we don't do the things that he say, we are a liar. Read.
But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another.
We have fellowship one with another because he's in the light. And if we walk in the light, we are in fellowship with one another. Am I right, brother?
That's right.
And the blood of Yahushua HaMashiach, his Son, cleanses us from all sins.
When he died on the cross for the Israelites' sin, it cleansed us from all sin and iniquity. Read.
If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves.
If we say that we don't sin, we are a liar and we deceive our own selves. Read.
And the truth is not in us.
Read, brother.
If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Read.
If we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar and his words is not in us.
See? Read what you got, brother.
My little children, these things write unto you that ye sin not. And if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Yahushua HaMashiach, the righteous. Mm-hmm. And he is the propitiation for our sins,
mm-hmm.
and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world.
The whole world of the Israelites.
That's right.
Because when he made this Bible and wrote this Bible, he wrote this Bible to the who?
Israelites.
He wrote this Bible for who?
The Israelites.
He didn't write it for the whole world. Read.
And hereby we do know that we know him.
This is how we know that we know the Most High. Read.
If we keep his commandments.
Wait a minute. What did the Bible say?
If we keep his commandments.
I thought the commandments were done away with.
If we keep his commandments. If he said, I know him and keepeth not his commandments, is a liar and the truth is not in him.
If you say that you know the Most High and you don't keep the law, statutes, and commandments, the Bible says that you are a liar and the truth is not in you. Am I right, brothers?
That's right.
But whoso keepeth his word, in him verily is the love of God perfect.
If you keep his word, the love of God is perfect in you. Read.
Hereby know we that we are in him.
Mm-hmm.
He that said he abideth in him ought himself also so to walk even as he walked.
If we say that we in Yahweh shop, we got to walk like he walked. Read.
Brethren, I write no new commandment unto you.
See, it's nothing new under the sun. Everything has been done before. And if you keep waking up, you'll see it again. Read.
But an old commandment which ye had from the beginning.
An old commandment. Read.
The old commandment is the word which ye have heard from the beginning. Again, in a new commandment I write unto you, which thing is true in him and in you. Because the darkness is past, and the true light now shineth.
That true light is the Most High, Yahawashah. Read.
He that said he is in the light and hated his brother is in darkness even unto now, until now.
Read, brother.
He that loveth his brother abideth in the light, and there is no occasion of stumbling in him. But he that hateth his brother is in darkness.
He that hateth his brother is in darkness. That's why when you see the black man, the so-called Mexican man, we brothers. But we've been taught by the white man to hate one another.
That's right.
That's to keep us separated, to keep us weak. But when we band together, we are the most powerful people on the face of the earth. Am I right, brothers?
That's right.
Read.
And walketh in darkness and knoweth not whither he goeth.
That's just like a blind man. He got to have something to direct him, a stick or something, to show him, to guide him where he's going. If he don't, he will what? He will stumble and fall. And that's the same way. If we don't have the true God in us, we stumble and we fall because of our sin and iniquities. Am I right, brothers?
That's right.
Read.
Because that darkness has blinded his eyes.
The darkness has blinded you. Read. Darkness is sin. Read.
I write unto you, little children, because your sins are forgiven you for his name's sake, I write unto you, fathers, because ye have known him that is from the beginning. I write unto you, young men, because ye have overcome the wicked one.
You have overcome the oppressor. Read.
I write unto you, little children, because ye have known the Father. I have written unto you, fathers, because ye have known him that is from the beginning. I have written unto you, young men, because ye are strong, and the word of God abideth in you. And ye have overcome the wicked one.
You have overcome the wicked one. You have overcome your oppressors. Because every time they do things to you, they try to kill you. We don't die, we multiply. Am I right, brothers?
That's right.
That's what the Bible say. Read on, brother.
Love not the world.
Wait a minute. What did the Bible just say?
Love not the world.
The Bible say love not the world. Read.
Neither the things that are in the world.
Homosexuality, murderers, adulterers, all those things are of the world. Read, brother.
If any man loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him.
You cannot love the world and love the Most High.
Right.
You cannot love two because you will be confused. You will want to serve one and you can't serve the other. You cannot serve two at the same time. Read.
For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, and the lust of the eyes,
read,
and the pride of life.
Come on.
Is not of the Father.
It's not of who?
Of the Father.
It's not of the Father, read.
But it's of the world.
It's of the world.
And the world passeth away.
And the world passeth away.
And the lust thereof. But he that doeth the will of God abideth forever.
Wait a minute. He say that he that does what, brother?
Does the will of God abideth forever.
The will of God is in the book of Psalms, chapter 40 and verse 8. It's keeping the law, statutes, and commandments. Read.
Little children, it is the last time. And as ye have heard that Antichrist shall come, even now are there many Antichrists. Whereby we know that it is the time.
Read.
They went out from us, but they were not of us.
They were not of us. Read.
For if they had been us, they would no doubt have continued with us.
If they would have knew us, they would have continued to stand strong in the faith. Read.
But they went out that they might be made manifest, that they were not all of us.
Yeah, all Israel is not Israel. Just because you're an Israelite doesn't mean that you're going to be able to make it to the kingdom. There's work that we have to do. There are things that the Most High require of us so that we can be able to get the kingdom. Am I right, brothers?
That's right.
We're not going to just be able to just walk in there because we are Israelites. There's work that we have to do. Read.
But ye have an unction from the Holy One,
mm-hmm.
and ye know all things. I have not written unto you because ye know not the truth, but because ye know it.
Read, brother.
And that no lie is of the truth.
Uh-huh.
Who is a liar but he that denies that Yahushua is the Hamakia?
Anybody that say that he's not the Christ, the Hamakia, they are the Antichrist. So the Antichrist has been here for a long, long time. It ain't just come here. Read.
He is an Antichrist that denies the Father and the Son.
Uh-huh.
Whosoever denies the Son, the same has not the Father.
Whosoever denies the Son, they don't know the Father. Because the Son, he's the way that you get to the Father. He's the mediator for the Father. Read.
But he that acknowledges the Son has the Father also.
If you acknowledge Yahusha, you acknowledge Yahweh as well. Read.
Let that therefore abide in you,
uh-huh.
which ye have heard from the beginning.
That ye have heard from the beginning.
If that which ye have heard from the beginning shall remain in you, ye also shall continue in the Son.
Read.
And in the Father.
Read, brother.
And this is the promise that he has promised us, even eternal life. These things have I written unto you concerning them that seduce you.
Uh-huh.
But the anointing which ye have received of him abideth in you.
The anointing abideth in you. See, because we have been seduced the same way that the white man seduced Eve. It wasn't no snake in no tree. It was a man that was teaching a false doctrine, and she took it back to her husband. Am I right, brothers?
That's right.
That's what happened. Read.
And ye need not that any man teach you.
Read.
But as the same anointing teacheth you of all things, and is truth, and is no lie, and even as it has taught you, ye shall abide in him.
Read.
And now the little children.
See, when he's talking about little children, he's not actually talking about little bitty kids. He's talking about older people, grown people, that has humbled themselves to be able to be retaught this word because you have been taught a wrong doctrine. Read.
Abide in him.
Yeah.
That when he shall appear, we may have confidence and not be ashamed before him at his coming.
Read.
If ye know that his righteous, ye know that everyone that doeth his righteousness is born of him.
If you know that you're seeing somebody that's out here doing righteousness, they are born of the Most High. If they are not doing righteousness, they have what? Become just like the heathens. They have become just like the devil. And the devil is the white man. It ain't no devil up on the ground with no pitchfork. With no red horns and all that stuff. You deal and see the devil every day. But nobody want to tell you the truth about that. Because they scared to come out here and bring God's unadulterated word to his lost children. Am I right, brothers?
That's right.
That's what the Bible says. Read.
Behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us. That we should be called the Son of God.
That we should be called what?
The sons of God.
No, that we should be called Gentiles.
Sons of God.
That we should be called heathens.
Sons of God.
Read.
Therefore, the world knoweth us not.
The world don't know us. Why they don't know us? Because they don't know the Father. Read.
Because they knew him not.
Mm-hmm.
Beloved, now are we the sons of God.
Mm-hmm.
And it doth not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him.
We shall be like him.
For we shall see him as he is. And every man that has this hope in him purifies himself.
Purifies himself. Cleanses himself. Read.
Even as he is pure. Whosoever committed sin transgresseth also the law.
Wait a minute. The Bible said that who does what, brother?
Whosoever committed sin transgresseth the law, also the law.
Whoever committed sin transgresses the law. Read.
For sin is a transgression of the law.
So how is the law going to be done away with when it says sin is the transgression of the law? Because they want to keep you in sin. If you don't keep these laws, statutes, and commandments, there's no way possible that you can qualify for the kingdom. Am I right, brothers?
That's right.
It just cannot happen. Read, brother.
And ye know that he has manifested to take away our sins.
Uh-huh.
In him is no sin.
Read.
Whosoever abideth in him sinneth not.
Whoever believe and does what the Most High said, they sinneth not. Read.
Whosoever sinneth has not seen him.
If you sinning, you don't know him. You ain't seen him. You can't be walking around thinking that you in grace and everything like that, because grace is a time period. You got to make yourself eligible to be able to get to the kingdom.
Neither know him. Little children, let no man deceive you.
Let no man what?
Deceive you.
The whole world has been deceived. Read.
He that doeth righteousness is righteous, even as he is righteous. He that committed sin is of the devil.
He that committed sin is of what?
Of the devil.
Is of what, brothers?
The devil.
He's of what, brothers?
Devil.
Read.
For the devil sinned from the beginning.
He sinned from the beginning, the devil did. Read. He came out of his mama's womb. He came out of Rebecca's womb from the beginning, sinning. Read.
For this purpose of the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil.
That he might destroy the works of the devil.
Whosoever is born of God do not commit sin.
Whoever is born of God does not commit sin. When you repent and turn from your wicked ways and stop sinning, you belong to the Most High. Am I right?
That's right.
Read.
For his seed remaineth in him.
For his seed remaineth in him. If I was to plant a peach, wherever I plant that peach at, that's what's going to come up. Am I right? If I'm planting dissension, that's what's going to come up. If I'm planting wickedness, that's what's going to turn out. You reap what you sow. That's what the Bible says.
That's right.
And he cannot sin because he is born of God.
He cannot sin because he's born of the Most High. Read.
In this the children of God are manifest.
Uh-huh.
In the children of the devil. Whosoever doeth not righteousness is not of God.
Read.
Neither he has that loveth not his brother.
See, if you don't love your brother, you ain't righteous. Ain't nothing good about you when you hate your brother. Read.
For this is the message that ye heard from the beginning.
This is the message that you heard from the beginning, that you should love your brother.
That's right.
Your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the laws and the prophet. It don't mean that just those two commandments are counted, but the other commandments are governed around those two. Am I right?
That's
love
right.
God and love your neighbor. All the rest of the commandments are governed around those, but all of them still stand. Read.
That we should love one another.
Mm-hmm.
Not as Cain, who was of that wicked one.
He was of that wicked one. He killed his brother. Read.
And slew his brother.
Uh-huh.
And wherefore slew he him, because his own works were evil.
His own works were evil.
And his brother was righteous.
And his brother was righteous.
Marvel not, my brethren, if the world hates you. We know that we have passed from death unto life.
Uh-huh.
Because we love the brethren.
Because we love who, brother?
The brethren.
Read.
He that loveth not his brethren abideth in death.
Uh-huh.
Whosoever hateth his brother is a murderer.
Wait a minute. What did the Bible say?
Whosoever hateth his brother is a murderer.
Whosoever hateth his brother is what?
A murderer.
Is what?
A murderer.
Is what?
A murderer.
Read.
And ye know that no murderer has eternal life.
No murderer has eternal life.
Abiding in him.
Huh?
Hereby perceive we the love of God, because ye laid down his life for us.
He did what?
Laid down his life for us.
He laid down his life for the sins of the Israelites. Read, brother.
And we ought to lay down our lives for the brethren.
So we should love our brother as well. We should be examples of the Most High. Am I right?
Right.
Read.
But whoso has this world's goods, and seeth his brother have need, and shutteth up his bowels of compensation from him, how dwelleth the love of God in him?
See, because, you know, you see your brother out there struggling, but you won't help him. But you'll go out there and you'll help that white man if he need a hand. But you won't help your brother because you hate seeing your brother have something. He might be able to have a little bit more than you, and you don't want your brother to have more than you. That's what the Bible is saying. Read, brother.
My little children, let us not love in word.
Don't love, don't say I love you. Show me you love me. Read.
Neither in tongue, but in deed and in truth.
And in deed and in truth, in action. Love is an action word. Am I right, brothers?
That's right.
That's what love is, an action word. We have to show. We can't just be talking this thing. We have to actually show that we love. Read.
And hereby we know that we are of the truth, and shall assure our hearts before him.
Uh-huh.
For if our hearts condemn us, God is greater than our heart.
He is greater than what?
Our heart.
Who knows your heart?
God.
The Most High knows your heart. Nobody else knows your heart. Read.
And knoweth all things.
He knows all things.
Beloved, is our heart condemned us.
Uh-huh.
Condemned us not. Then have we confidence towards God.
We have confidence towards who, brothers?
God.
Need.
And whatsoever we ask, we receive of him.
And whatsoever we ask, we do what?
Receive of him.
How do we receive the things that we ask of him? Read.
Because we keep his commandments.
Because we keep his commandments.